Hello everyone, let's learn today Norma Occipitalis. Now we know Norma Occipitalis is the posterior view of the skull. So in the posterior view, what we see is the posterior part of the parietal bones. Now these are the parietal bones, you can see over here. So its posterior part is visible in Norma Occipitalis. Now this portion, it is the squamous part of the occipital bone. And over here, small portion on either side. This is the mastoid temporal bone or mastoid part of the temporal bone. Over here you can see. So this is squamous part of the temporal bone and this portion is called as mastoid part of the temporal bone. So these many bones are seen from behind. Now let's see sutures. Over here you can see this is posterior part of the sagittal suture. See this. This is sagittal suture. This is coronal suture. So posterior part of the sagittal suture is visible in Norma Occipitalis. Now this suture, it is called as lambdoid suture, and that is between parietal bone and squamous occipital bone. Now over here you can see another suture that is between the mastoid part and parietal part. Above it is called as parietomastoid suture. And over here you can see that is between mastoid part and occipital part. So that is called as occipitomastoid suture. So four sutures are seen in Norma Occipitalis, namely posterior part of the sagittal suture, lambdoid suture, the parietomastoid suture and occipitomastoid suture. Now certain bony landmarks. Over here you can see two foramina and these are called as parietal foramina. Now the portion of the sagittal suture between two parietal foramina, over here, this is called as obelion. Now it is considered as the part which represents third eye. Now parietal foramina will allow passage of emissary vein that connects scalp to the superior sagittal sinus. Now over here, meeting point of the sagittal suture with the lambdoid suture, over here, this portion is called as lambda, and this is a point where posterior fontanelle lies. And that gets fused in first 2 to 3 months of the life. So this is lambda. Obviously the shape is like a lambda, so as the name given is to lambda. Still below in the midline, the prominent part over here in the squamous occipital bone, this is called as external occipital protuberance. Over here you can see. Now on either side from the external occipital protuberance, two curved lines will run from medial to lateral with concavity facing down like this. These are termed as superior nuchal lines. So external occipital protuberance and two superior nuchal lines, these are the demarcations for head and neck. So beyond that, the neck starts, and obviously this is the line or this is the demarcation of Norma Occipitalis. Beyond that, Norma Basalis starts. So in the midline there is external occipital protuberance. Above it provides attachment to the trapezius, below it provides attachment to the uppermost part of the ligamentum nuchae. Now this is external occipital protuberance, and in the midline the most prominent point over here, this is termed as INION. Just above the INION, this portion is called as occipital point, which is the farthest point from the glabella. Now glabella, you know, it's a midpoint or imaginary midpoint between two superciliary arches. Now if you take an anteroposterior diameter or anteroposterior distance, this will be the farthest. So from glabella, the farthest point anteroposteriorly is the occipital point. Now the superior nuchal line, medially they provide attachment to the trapezius, and laterally it provides attachment to two muscles: sternocleidomastoid above and splenius capitis below. Now sometimes parallel to the superior nuchal line, 1 cm above to the superior nuchal line, there runs two another lines. These are termed as highest nuchal lines because they are situated above to the superior nuchal line. So these are termed as highest nuchal lines. Now again, medially it provides attachment to the epicranial aponeurosis or galea aponeurotica, and laterally it provides attachment to the occipital belly of occipitofrontalis or occipitalis muscle. Now over here, this is mastoid temporal bone. Now this is occipital mastoid suture, and over here you can see a foramen. Let me bring it closer. Over here you can see a foramen. This is called as mastoid foramen. Obviously it is found in the mastoid bone, so as the name given is mastoid foramen, and deep inside it opens into the sigmoid sulcus. Over here, let me show you. This is transverse sulcus and this is the sigmoid sulcus, and over here you can see a foramen. So that is the opening of internal opening of the mastoid foramen over here, and two structures are passing through it. One is emissary vein and second is meningeal branch of occipital artery. Now sometimes at the apex of squamous occipital bone, a small piece of bone is found. This is called as interparietal bone. It's not a sutural bone or accessory bone, but it's the membranous part of the occipital bone which fails to fuse with the cartilaginous part. So here sometimes we may get interparietal bone near lambda. So that is about Norma occipitalis. Hope you understood well. Thanks for watching.